Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. We're back here at 20 Mile Bay at Harrison Lake, and I won't showcase the campground too much because that was done in a previous video. Daisy and Maggie are in the bush goofing around hunting for chipmunks. Anyways, I thought we'd showcase a few new things happening to our rigs. So as you know, here's my four-wheel pop-up camper. You've seen that before. And I've showcased before in another video the Mosquito Lake video where Otto had his new van out. And I told you guys showcase a little bit about it. So here we go. Let's get into it. And Alex is here with his new van and his old trailer. So let's start with Otto's van right now. And here we go. This is Otto's new van. And it's still in mid-construction, probably a lot of stuff to go still. So what do we got going on here? What is the wheelbase of this van here? Probably a lot of people want to know that.
So this is a Mercedes Sprinter. It's a 170 wheelbase, 4x4. I decided to build most of the structure inside with aluminum 8020 instead of plywood. So we can go to the back of the van and get an idea of what we're looking at.
So we have your traditional bed over garage. So here's the aluminum structure. The bed is just temporary. There's going to be a mattress at some point here. Basically threw this together quick enough for this particular trip. So tell us a little bit about the need for the gear garage here, Otto.
So The garage is really for our scuba equipment. So we added scuba divers. We also do cleanups with Henry on the lakes and stuff. So the end product will have a bed slide type system here in the bottom. We will be able to store all our scuba tanks, up to 6 scuba tanks down at the bottom, and then all our dive gear in totes above that. And that all fits under the bed. And then on both sides of the bed, it's held up by these two aluminum structures. On the driver's side, this structure will carry all the electronics or all the electrics of the vehicle. So we'll have our batteries in there, inverter, temporary solar charger, solar chargers and temporary solar panels in there. And on the passenger side, we'll have all our water. So we'll have water tanks, hot water heater, water pumps, etc.
Now you're going with lithium, right?
Yeah, we're going with lithium batteries.
How many amp are you going with?
So we're going with 3 100-amp lithium.
Right, that's nice. And I see your fridge is all the way in the front.
Yeah, and currently I'm using an angled fridge between the seats. We'll decide if we'll change that later, but I do have the fridge, so we'll be using that.
Right, so obviously kitchen is going to be in our traditional place.
Yeah.
Let's go around to the front. So the kitchen will be in a traditional place on that side or on this side?
On this side, right, at the door, and then a dinette on the other side, on the driver's side will be a dinette.
We can see. Very nice. People. And it looks like you got a very skookum roof rack.
Yeah, so you got a roof rack there that will eventually hold 2 330-watt solar panels on the roof, plus some place for storage. So that'll give us a lot of power. Top-up power that we need as we go along on that one. We decided to sleep lengthwise, north-south, so we got a full-length bed in there and just shy of a king size in width.
That was a very nice little tour. We'll come back to the van once he makes more progress on it so you can see what that looks like. Any questions about this van, just post them in the question below or post in the comments below and I'll try to answer them. And over here, we have Big Blue. Alex's van.
Hi.
So what's the difference between the two vans for starters?
So, besides the color, I have something called flares from Flare Space, which are these black things on the side which extend out about 4 inches. They're on both sides of the van. So these actually mean that I sleep east-west rather than north-south in the van. So it actually gives me about 18 more inches of floor space. So I have my kitchen cabinet built but not fully finished. And it goes a little bit deeper. And then on the other side, I'll actually be able to put a shower inside, which is the only real difference. The garages will be similar, mine being a little bit shorter. And then I'm flipping electricity and water, so my power goes on the passenger side and my water goes on the driver's side.
Are the vans same size?
Same size, both 170s, both 4x4 Sprinters.
Right, so the difference here is that Alex didn't have to have his bed built because he brought his trailer to sleep in. So in here, unlike Otto's where his bed structure is up, Alex's bed structure isn't up yet. So basically kitchen right here. And are you gonna have a dinette on this?
A dinette facing forward. The front seats on this one have this swivel. It's kind of hard to see. We've got our fake curtain up, but they do swivel. So that swivels around. And then right where the green bins are will be the dinette.
Nice, perfect.
So the other thing is this is also 80-20. This is the 10 series, so it is 1 inch. A lot of people, we see people using the 1.5 inch or asking what size this is typically used. So this is the 1 inch and it is more than sturdy enough for pretty much everything that gets built. So this is actually where the fridge goes and stuff like that. And it's very strong.
Very nice. So any question about Alex's van, drop in the comments, I'll answer them. But the key thing I want to show you guys in this video is Alex's adventure trailer. This thing is super cool. So this is a 100% custom built from the ground up. We commissioned, or Alex commissioned, a aluminum trailer builder. They built a ton of these aluminum trailer frames for everything, from boats to
transport trailers,
yeah, gardening,
horse trailers,
yeah, all in aluminum.
They also do custom aluminum work, so they make saddle boxes like this for, you know, industrial use in the logging industry. They make custom roof racks. They make custom headache racks for pickup trucks. They do a lot of custom aluminum work. It's basically all they do. And they're very experienced builders and welders, which is also nice.
So let's do a walk around. Let's start with the front here.
So at the beginning, we've got a standard ball hitch on this one, but it is through bolted, so it can be swapped out for an off-road hitch if people want to. A nice big sturdy shield. Behind that is a standard 20-pound propane tank. The idea behind that is that these are easy to swap out. Any place that has, you know, standard propane tank barbecue swap, you can trade it out. You don't need to track down a place to fill it.
Over here we have our electricals.
Yep, so batteries are on that side. They're two giant GC2 golf cart style batteries under there. And then in here we've got all the electricals crammed in. We've got two solar chargers, one for the rooftop mounted solar panel, which is a 330-watt solar panel, and one for the small portable solar panel, which is out there. And then we've got DC plug-in or AC plug-in charging, as well as a massive inverter at the bottom to run some of the goodies in the kitchen.
All right, well, seeing as this side is open, why don't we go around to the kitchen side?
So we have the fridge, which lives in here. So behind a sealed door on a slide is one of the Dometic's 65-liter fridges. And this thing works really, really well. They're very power efficient. It's fairly deep. You can put enough food for about 2 weeks with one person, or about a week with two people. It just slides back in. Above it is a storage shelf for a propane stove.
Which is that one there.
Yeah.
Custom fit.
Yeah, so that fits in there. Straps to strap it down so it doesn't rattle around.
Okay, and then we have our very, very neat kitchen area, protected by an awning.
Yeah, so we have the nice awning, which is just ARB awnings, which are amazing. The electrical system for the trailer runs here, which includes the lights, inverter on off, water pump, the outlets. I had comms, so there is space for a cell booster LTE modem behind this panel. And we've got a 12-volt outlet and USB charge, and there's a nice big pocket here to put whatever you need to charge.
So this entire thing right here is custom built as well too?
Yep. This is custom made. I designed and built this to go in. And then we've got an espresso coffee machine, which sits on a slide, so you can bring it forward to put water in it.
And that just stays with the trailer. That's built in.
That's built in, runs off the inverter. I'm enjoying a coffee right now from it. It's very, very convenient. And then we have a little bit more storage underneath. We have water, so we have running water on board the trailer. What Henry won't be able to show you is the two massive water tanks underneath, protected by a skid plate. So we carry just shy of 50 gallons of fresh water behind a quarter-inch aluminum skid plate. So it will go over anything rather than through it.
That's pretty cool. And you got some food storage area there, dishes.
Food storage, dishes, whatever you need kind of fits in. And then behind that, you fall to, we've got nice stabilizer jacks that are rated for more than the weight of the trailer. So you can actually jack the whole trailer up. We've done that before. When you end up in a campsite that's really not level, you can go up about a foot if you need to with the trailer on any corner.
So on this side here, you have a matching saddle box.
Yep. Step around here. So this is normally workshop area. You know, it's just kind of empty. Milk crates just seem to fit perfectly and lock in. So you have space for that.
Very nice. Now you got an extra, got a spare tire set in the back here. Now, what happens to be hiding behind that giant spare tire? Look at that.
So this was built to carry scuba gear or anything else really that needs to come with you.
How many pounds does that tray hold?
About 1,000 pounds.
Nice.
So we have a little bit of wood on it right now. It's not really even noticing it. But yeah, it's good for 1,000 pounds and it's easy to slide in and out with gear.
As you guys probably figured out by now, all of our overland rigs are all centered around scuba diving, as the primary thing that we do is actually go and remove garbage from lakes, do our cleanup dives. So every build that we do is, except for the four-wheel camper that was just bought the way it is, it wasn't built around scuba diving, but scuba gear. So where do you sleep, Alex? Look at that. So what was that, 20 seconds? Not even.
Yeah.
18 seconds.
So that's a Bundu top that comes from South America, South Africa. The fabric on it's super, super durable. It's beyond waterproof. I've been through some pretty terrible weather here in BC, and it just, yeah, it really doesn't seem to care about it or wind. It's very sturdy. It's a twin. It's 54 inches wide, roughly, and about just shy of 7 to 8 inches long on the mattress. So it's super comfortable, easy to set up, and because of the solar panel, even on a hot day, it stays nice and cool up there.
Well, there you go, guys. There's a little walkthrough of the rigs that we have. Thanks to Otto. All right, so if you got any questions about either one of the rigs, you guys are probably familiar with my camper already, but any questions about at all, just drop them in the comments below. And the next trip that will be out is gonna be a cleanup dive, our first one. We took August off because it's just too hot for us to function in August heat in our dry suit. So we took August off. We traditionally do that anyways. So we are back to cleanup diving in September, which is the next trip out. We're gonna be heading to Weaver Lake, not that far away from 20 Mile Bay. So thanks for sticking me with this video. See you guys in the next one.